And I find that religion is a sensitive topic in today's society, you know. And you know what I mean? To be frank, you know what I mean? My perspective and outlook on it is deeply rooted in Christianity, you know. And that's what I believe. So I mean, that's not offensively and aggressively attacking other the beliefs of others, or aggressively attacking, you know what, or aggressively imposing, you know, to or twisting arms and just, you know, making, you know, like forcefully imposing my beliefs on anyone else. That's not what I'm about, you know. That's not what I do. That's not who I am, you know. But we're here in the world to bring light, you know, and to speak truth, you know. And there's lots of different perspectives on that, you know. And that's why I say, you know, it is, it seems. You know what I mean? As for me and my household, we shall believe. So that's acknowledging the reality that there are other beliefs and belief systems and things that, you know, function in the world. But that's no, you know, that's no, you know, it's not directly, you know, like it's not a concept that's directly linked to, you know, the purpose of what I'm trying to do, or where I am, or where I'm trying to head, you know, as a person. And and my main goal is just to do the will of the Father. That's what I want to do. That's what I want to do, the will of the Most High. So, you know, that's what a lot of my work is going to gravitate around. From start all the way up to this point, a lot of my work embraces that reality, you know, and has a lot of that has a Christian overtone on it, you know, because that's what I represent, that's what I, you know, that's what I love, you know. I love the Lord and I love God. I want to do what's right in the eyesight of, you know. And that's what a lot of my work does revolve around. I have work as well, and I'm proud of it, you know. I'm not ashamed of it. And I have work that doesn't necessarily, you know, speak on, you know, my beliefs, you know. You know what I mean? And I have work that, you know, that stem off from it, my beliefs, you know. But I mean, that's at the end of the day, that's what I believe. That's what I want to do. You know, that's what God wants me to do, you know. So I know it's a sensitive topic and it's stirring much controversy. Well, really it shouldn't, you know, really shouldn't. But the conflicting interest, you know, has created turmoil, you know, in more ways than one. It's conflicting interest in regards to, you know, things like poetry. You know, it's, poetry is big. Poetry is huge. You know, it's stemmed out from something. You know, it's stemmed out all the way from the Bible. You know, I mean, the Psalms is poetry. The Book of Psalms. You know, man. And so, you know, in today's world as well, it's all converted. Forms of this art, you know. So, and then with each and every form of this art, has different beliefs of individuals, different beliefs, systems, and coming from different backgrounds and things, you know. But like I said again, at the end of the day, it's what I believe, it's what I want to do, this is what I am, you know. And so, that's to be expected from me. Doesn't mean you're wrong for being different. You know, on another note, you know, it's not detrimental to not think the same. Blinded by the workers, say you did. I can reiterate things 100 times over. It's not going to help anyone see and don't want to understand. Committed to me is understanding. You know? There's more to me than just the things I've had in time to. Because, like, some only don't know the eyes of some. Strongly about it. Like now, I look at it, you know, as just second hand. You know, like I look at, reciting the poems and stuff, second hand, writing it first though. That's the dominant. You know, the dominant effect. I'm a writer, but reciting it calls out. But either way, it's still my body of work. You know, so I can do it. And so it's been all kind of, you know, informal restrictions set, you know, on what I can express and what I can't, you know, due to threat of unrest, you know, because others, you know, I mean, feel as though, I guess, it's a problem. I don't think it's a problem. And it was never a problem until I started shining. And that's when people try to attach themselves to me to make a problem where it didn't exist. I keep that line drawn. All of the money forces and powers will fall, but I just ask God to have mercy on some souls, because God is not mocked. He's merciful. He tries to save because he knows the influence and impact that some can have on his kingdom. I'm not the only one with talent in the world, you know. And I recognize that. And, you know, as bad as I do, you know, as much as I do, you know, I'm not so much enthralled because of my direction and trajectory. So I don't really. Most of everything that I perceive is attacking me in some way. You know, not due to me with some crazy kind of delusion thinking or some kind of anything, you know, mind thing, thinking that people after me or something. It's not that kind of ordeal. You know, it's a real living, breathing, proof back, you know, of reality and manifestations. That have been, you know, dealt in time, you know, in past times and days past. Yeah. Nonetheless, though, you know what I mean? Love my heart, man. Love what I do. I work hard, you know. Hard for this, what I believe in, no with no pay. You know, this is what I live for. The Lord in poetry, you know. Never received a dime for any of my poems, ever. You know, for any of my work. That's not saying I'm gonna be foolish to think that, you know, like God gave me the power to get wealth for myself that I wouldn't take. Anything else, you know. You know, as far as, you know, in the physical world. I need that survival either. Just, you know. But I mean, God supplies I need, so I'm fine. Your poetry is more to me than a hobby or anything. This is everything to me. I don't believe none of the lies of the devil, man. All that discredited and degraded junk, I see right through it. You know, I know my worth and I know my value as a person, as an artist. You know, as an artist, I know my value. You know, and I'm not for to internalize nothing that contradicts what God has already told me. The things that God tells me and told me, nobody knows. You know? And then there's much that's already been put out. That was inspired by his spirit. The devil just unraveling his own kingdom, you know, in a way. Because God is that this stone that can't be shaken. I plead the blood of Jesus over my life. Lives of all those. strongholds and satanic chains and everything. Bring me fetish and bigglements. Hooks and tentacles. Spells, all of this. Magic, white magic, black magic. I pronounce it, pull it down. In the name of Jesus. Destroy his name. And his fruits in each of the lives of the saints. Of the enemy, you know, are cursed. All the money, foot soldiers and workers of the of Satan, you are nothing. You are cast down. In the name of Jesus, you are not allowed around. In the name of Jesus, I'm bound you. I'm bound you. It's all out. Get away from our prison. In the name of Jesus, destruction. You go into the abyss of darkness. In the name of Jesus, that's what you see. Blind, deaf, mute, anything that we say or do, unless we speak directly to you in the name of Jesus. Power, man. Power, we got it. We got the power to change our lives, our own lives. And no one can change before. We the heroes of our own stories. We have to be, you know, we have to be the heroes of our own life. Nobody gonna do it for us. And if they do, they be robbing and cheating themselves for that testimony experience and what you that potential, you know, that you can give, that potential light and that piece of your puzzle that the world needs. You know, the world needs the kingdom needs you. Something God put inside you. Something God put inside you that can strongly benefit purpose. I ain't let Satan take my testimony. Never. You know? In the name of Jesus, you know, through the power of the Lord, not my own power. Not happy coming up. God bless you.